All right, these guys might not look like they're ready. They're not even harnessed yet. But this is Comet here. This is going to be one of our leaders today. Hi, Comet. You're such a good boy. Actually, usually let a lot more dogs loose. But while I'm harnessing the dogs that are loose always want to be next to me. So I end up with like 5 dogs around me. And that can get a little cumbersome and hard to work, right? You understand? But you're okay. Anyway, I'm going to introduce you to the dogs as I harness them. And then we're going to go take that dog sled over there for about a 5-mile loop. Trails today are, it's March here. And so the trails are really slick. And so too fast for big teams. Like they're really icy. And so it makes it really hard for us to stop and control the team. So typically I like to take 8 or 10 dogs with me. But today I'm just taking 6. That'll give me enough to control. Also, I'm planning on going up a steep, well, it's kind of steep, a hill, but it's a windy, narrow trail with a tight turn. And 6 dogs is more than enough. 8 dogs makes the turn really hard. All right, let me try to do this while talking. All right, so anyways, I got the harnesses. These are done by size, so small, medium, large, extra large, which I have in my hand. This is one white one. I need more of those. And these are just kind of miscellaneous ones for different dogs. All right, so you already met Comet. Come here, Comet. Leo, how'd you get off? Leo, come here. What did you do? Did I just not hook you? How did that happen? Leo, you're so good. All right, come here. Let's try this again. So unfortunately, I have a chesty on my body here, so the dog's gonna be a little closer. I'm not sure how good this angle's gonna be for you. But it'd be good to have a head one on instead, but the head one, then I have to have an external battery strapped to my head and all sorts of stuff. Anyways, this is Leo. Leo, you're way too close to the camera. Leo is he's my main leader, actually. He's the one I trust to turn the team, take big teams on new trails, and all sorts of stuff. He's just a really good dog. He's from Trailbreaker Kennel, which is, if anyone knows who Susan Butcher was. Susan Butcher was a really famous Iditarod musser. Leo. She passed away in the early 2000s. But her kennel and her lines still live on. Comet is actually from her lines as well. Aren't you, Comet? Comet's a little stud. He's my other good leader. Comet will go on trails that are barely even seen by other dogs. And I can tell him, go on that trail. And Comet finds it and takes the team there. Come here. He did that yesterday, actually. He turned our team. We had to do like a 120-degree turn the other day. And Comet was there and made the team turn. Anyways, this is Comet. He's 6. Come here, Comet. Look at that leg. He's the size. Oh, you know what? Comet, you're not that size anymore. Well, you can wear that today. You can wear that. Yes. Good lead dog. So my two leaders, Leo and Comet. And then down the line, I did this guy last. This is this brown dog here. This is Merlin. Hey, Merlin. How are you, big guy? Huh? I do him last because he can chew his harness. He gets excited. And then next thing you know, you turn around and the harness is chewed in half. So you wait. You go at the end. Oh, now there's Sarabi. Sarabi, my little girl. This girl. She's a somewhat famous Iditarod dog. So if you just look up Sarabi, Iditarod. And Sarabi is spelled S-A-R-A-B-I. Sarabi. She was a 2014, 16? I forget when you ran. Sarabi's named after the Lion King. I think it's, are you Simba's mom? Is that who you are? So that's Sarabi. Most litters have some type of theme, like Comet. Comet is named after a coffee cafe in, I want to say Minnesota, right? And his sister is Lulu. Lulu's here in the kennel. She's named after Lulu's Cafe here in Fairbanks. And yeah, so they all have themes, usually, like Leo. Now, you'll be able to guess this one really quick. Leo's brother is Virgo and Sagittarius. All right, you already figured it out, I bet. And what was that other one? I forgot the name of him. It'll come to me in a minute. He's got lots of brothers. This is Stripe. Stripe's a hound mix. Hounds were high. Comet always wants to see. This is the thing with loose dogs. They just want to be around you all the time while I'm harnessing. So anyway, Stripe here, he's a husky hound mix, which is very popular here in Alaska when you want to have a sprint dog. So he's got like short haired pointer in him. He is strong. He's also a dog I can let loose in the yard, and he sticks right on ya. All right, then I need to get a different harness for this dog. This guy here, he's new. We're not sure if he's gonna make the cut. He's cute, he's great, he's a fun pet. Not quite a sled dog. His name's Hercules, and I got him from a person that was in the military that came up and they wanted a husky, which a lot of people when they come to Alaska want huskies. The problem is huskies are meant to pull sleds and run a lot, and they want him as a pet, and he just tore their house apart, didn't he? Did you tear their house apart? So yeah, he needs exercise and lots of it, and a different harness, because he can chew too. He is totally rookie. You'll see as we go today, he might not even pull that hard. So, which means he might not make the cut. So, and if that's the case, we keep him as a pet or as a yard dog, or we just find a home for him for someone who wants a really high energy dog. If you're training for a marathon, this would be the dog, wouldn't you? Are you going to be a marathon trainer? You could do that. When it comes to work ethic, though, you don't really have a lot. Anyways, you'll see how he goes. He's learning, though. I mean, the harness goes on him well, and this is not the harness for you. I got the wrong one. Talking too much. Well, I'll give him... You better not chew this harness, or you're going to hear me curse. These are brand new harnesses, but this will fit him. There's Comet. All right, you ready, buddy? This goes on you, right? So I like to put him in the back of the team when they're training so they can see all the other dogs around him. And that way he can, you know, he learns by watching. I could put him next to Sarabi. No, actually, I'm going to put him next to Stripe. Stripe has work ethic you wouldn't believe. So he's a good trainer for this guy. And that's how they learn to pull. You find the good dog, like a Comet, which trains. You've trained a couple leaders. Yes, you have. You trained our up-and-coming rising stars. All right, then Merlin. This is Merlin here. He's gorgeous, though, isn't he? Look at how big he is. Yes, you very stoic build. With your little tiny feet. He's only 2 years old. And he... easy, buddy, easy. He could use a little more training. Chewing harnesses, chewing lines, things like that. You know, puppies sometimes do that, but they really need to be trained not to do that, because it can get expensive and dangerous if they chew a line or a harness while you're running. Lots of kisses, thank you. Sorry, this chesty I'm sure isn't helping much when the dogs jump on me. So, yeah, just six dogs. Comet gonna lead with Leo, Merlin, Sarabi. Look at you, you're so funny looking. You're so fun. And then this guy, I don't know what to do with this dog. Oh my God. And Stripe. Alright, so here's the sled. I have mitts. Hush, Sonic. You're so loud. And so I'm gonna line him up on this sled. We have the gang line set up. You'll get to watch that. Again, this chesty doesn't make it that easy for you to follow along, but hopefully you can see what's going on. This guy will just follow me there. So you wanna be the leader today? Let's go, let's walk up there. Well, we're ready to go. Six dogs, they get ready quick. All right, so this is a neckline for the leaders. I put this on this collar here. This is just gonna hold him in place while I get the rest of the team there. And this goes on his back. This is a tug, just like that. And Sarabi. Sarabi's gonna be my swing dog. Of course, she gets a neckline. And a tug. And you guys just watch these young ones. Make sure they don't chew anything. Don't chew anything. So he's gonna go, you're up, Stripe. Easy, easy. You're strong. You're so strong. You're so strong. going to get my... Look at this guy. So, if he chews a line, you're going to see me. I'm going to bonk him on the head with a glove or something. That usually cheats him pretty quick. Hey, you just relax, man. He's already picking fights. Don't be a jerk. All right. Thunderhead. Easy, stay down. Strawberry, you need to move over. And then this guy. Put this on his neck. Come here, give me a bite. Strawberry, you gotta move over. There you go. And then make sure no one chews anything. It does get loud. And you're ready. These two, Leo and Comet, they don't lead together a lot. Oh, I don't know if you can hear me right now. Alright, they're ready. Alright, nobody's chewing anything. Alright. Gotta get these gloves on. As quick as I can. Get this hook in. And one more line of safety here. This is quick release. And we're off. Alright. Alright guys, easy. This, I'm still on my property here. Nice out. Oh, there's a raven. This is when they're at their strongest and most excited. They're a little talkative. The new guy in the back is hogging the whole trail. He doesn't know how to share yet. Stripe will fix him, I bet. Right, crossing the road. There we go. Good. All right. Not quite on the main trail yet, but we're getting there. So it's still a little soft. It's kind of nice. It's easy for me to steer and control them, but the main trail will be on there in about a half mile, not even. That's going to be fast and icy. It gets cold at night, so everything freezes, and then during the day, it warms up, gets above 30, 35 degrees. Get a little water on top of the trails. It freezes at night. It just becomes a sheet of ice. All right, heading in the way. It's that noise you hear, you probably hear it. Oh my, drag, it's at my underneath my feet. It's a piece of snow machine track or snowmobile track. It's got some little spikes in it. It just helps me control the speed when I step on it. If I let go of it, sorry, so Robbie's pooping. Poop and run. Now you know what sled dogs do. How they poop. They don't stop. So anyways, I'm gonna step off this drag. You'll probably hear it. But the speed picks up quite a bit. Woo! It's probably a little too fast to start with, so I'd like to keep it controlled. There's a biker coming up. I think. Here, a biker? We need to get off the trail. The dog teams have the right of way, and they're not paying attention. Come on, guys, wake up. Hey, let's go, trail. I'm trying to get the poles over. There we go. All right, guys, go. Thanks. Oh, I gotta watch this turn. There we go, good. Trails are usually, you know, they don't freeze and thaw every day, so they're not like ice and cement like they are right now. So you can take bigger teams. This is my favorite. I like 10 dogs. If I had four more dogs in the front of here, I really like 10 dogs. Good power, good speed, it's fun. and the trails are good. You got good control over them. I think the dogs like it too when they have the rest of the team with them. Good Lord, Merlin, or not Merlin. A new dog. So what you look for when they're pulling, right, is that the tug lines, the lines that connect their harnesses to the main line, right? So it's right on their butts, right? There's a little line that connected. Those should be nice and tight. That means they're pulling, right? If they slack or they bounce a lot, that means the dog Hercules, figure this out. They can duck under the line, right? So you see how he's right next to the stripe. He's just the dogs figure it out. They can go under the line and stuff. They can go over that main line. I can help them sometimes. I don't know if you'll be able to see this, but push the sled forward. The gang line's gonna drop a little bit. And usually when it drops, the dog that's on the wrong side of the line will jump over it. But see if Hercules figures that out. Okay, I'm gonna do it right now. Nope, he's just gonna get. Can you do it again? There you go. Come on, figure it out. There you go. Nope, now you got him on the. Now you got one on each side. Herc. Nope. All right. Whoa, take a break. Hercules, figure it out. Come on, step over it. Look at him eating snow. It's hot. It's like 30. Look at him. He's not fixing his leg. Fix your leg. Hercules. Herc. Fix your leg. Step over to the line. His front leg's over the line, right under his armpit. Probably can't see that. We'll see if he fixes it. If not, I'll stop again. Most of it, they can fix that. That's not a big worry. Okay, let's go. Hey, I think he fixed it. Yeah, good job. Old Stream Valley. They're multi-use. These aren't like state or city maintained trails. It's mostly just people like ourselves going out there with our dogs, skis, snow machines. Some people will help groom them, keep them smooth when we get big snowfalls. We'll go out here with our chainsaws. If it's a heavy wet snow, sometimes it will cause the trees to fall on the trail. What am I going to do here? Fuck a weapon. Gee! There you go. Oh, there's a snow machine on this. Yeah. Alright, yeah. This will be fun going down. Ooh, and into the woods we go. Up on top here is this big. Well, it's a big field, but it's a hay field. And we're going to loop around it. I think we're going to loop around it. Not many people go up there with a... Usually skiers and bikers go around it. So the trail might not be that good right now because we got a little bit of snow. That's it. Up. Awesome. I got to cook. This is going to be fun to go down. This big icy... Whoa, there's a new trail. Oh, so you gotta get the loose dogs out of the way. My team will totally run over them. Ah, great. How many loose dogs I got up there? One. Okay, let's go. There we go. Good job, guys. That's it. Keep going. Thank you. Yeah, a nice dog. Came right back to her. I like that. All right, now we're going to come out in the hay field. Nice. Look pretty up here. Good job, guys. So it looks like a snow machine or a snowmobile through from the lower 48 came through this trail, which is good for us, makes the trail easy, but it's actually supposed to be a non-motorized trail. But oh well. I don't know if you can see the mountains in the range, but holy cow, they are out way, 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 way off over there. Beautiful. It's the Alaska Range. Keep it easy, guys. Cool, we got this big loop we're gonna take around this whole field. We're gonna go back down that hill and then we're gonna turn towards home. It's a, all together, it's a 5 mile loop. And that's, yeah, it's not a lot for us, but 20, 25, typically what we do. Everybody's snow dipping again, I might stop. I'm sure they would do it, but there's no need for us to do that this late in the season. Oh, Sarabi's caught. Sarabi, fix it. Oh. All right, so that I might have to fix. Merlin, you okay? So sometimes, you fix it? He's almost there. He fixed it, nice. So my leaders are getting some snow. Yeah, it's hot, it's hot. So the main line down the middle is the gang line. It's made out of, it's a cable. It's a plastic coated cable. Ready? Okay. I don't worry about that line. That's not going to tangle the dogs. They can go up and under and over it. Hercules even figured it out, right? But the neck line, the one you saw me connect them to, their collar, which connects them to the gang line, if they step over that, then it's underneath their armpit. It's a pretty hard thing for them to fix on their own, though. Merlin just fixed his own, so that was nice. But typically you have to stop and fix that because it's really hard when your neckline is underneath your armpit to just get it off. Airplane, look at that, that's cool. You might not be able to see it, but there's an airplane over there. We're gonna go right by it actually, because my trail turns right in front of it, so that's cool. Look at that. Nothing says Alaska like a dog team going past a airplane on skis. No trail here. There you guys go. There you go. There you go. Easy, guys. Easy. Yeah, there's no trail here. Crazy, though. Oh. A bit uphill. Sorry, I'm moving the camera around, I'm sure. I got putting this phone back in my pocket. Hey, look, there's a... No, you can't see it either. I don't know if you can see that, but there's a glider person landing. Hopefully not in the trees over there, but I think we're going to go right by him. What's he doing? It's a surf thing. What's that called? When you're on a... I can't even talk right now. You're on your snowboard, but you have a kite. Kite surfing, kite boarding. I think we're gonna go right by one here in a second. Oh, what an adventurous day. I guess that's the cool thing about good weather. I mean, I like having the trails to myself because I'm selfish, but you see cool things like that airplane and what I think we're about to see here. Is, oh my God, the dogs are gonna be like, what the hell is that? Yeah, he's about to cross the trail. I can kind of see. Nice. Oh, that's it. This, what the heck is going on here? So no more. You can kind of see the hard pack right in front of us, and then it's going to be all soft snow. So if the dogs fall off the hard pack trail, or if I fall off the hard pack trail, I'm 3 feet of powder. Easy, guys. Cool. All right, let's go. There you go, easy. I think I might have made her lose that. I made her go faster than she wanted. Oh, well. All right, right-hand turn coming up here. Little guy in the trail. There you go, good. Nice, there you go. How do you do? Alright, now I'm gonna help him. I don't know if you can see my shadow. See my shadow? I'm kicking. I have 1 foot on one runner and my other runner's kicking. And if you look at Herc, see how Herc, again, rookie dog, looking around at the people and the kites and all the other ones are just very work ethic, good work ethic for all the other dogs. Outside of the snow dipping, which is not bad work ethic. Ugh, I can't talk. Snow dipping is not bad work ethic, it's just hot dogs. So we'll stop up here when we get to the top. But yeah, Hercules has no work ethic. Ugh, I can't say that. Hercules is not a good worker. His tug line, he's almost tripping on his tug line, it's dragging on the ground. Yeah. Oh, Herc. I'm not picking on him, he's just... Oh, now he's pulling something. Yeah. Alright, here we go, guys. I'm gonna go down this hill. I'm gonna go slow the whole way. There you go. Good. Oh, Hercules, you're already screwed up on your line. There you go. Hey, fixed it. Nice. Nice and easy, guys. Nice and easy. I got my foot on the drag and the brake at the same time here. Trying to keep some control. Down these crusty, hard trails. Easy, easy. There you go. Nice and easy. Good area. One turn coming up here that always a lot of fun. This one right here. I'm gonna hit that. Oh, I didn't hit that bad. Good. Nice, guys. Very good. Very good. I'm lucky. That's good dog. Controlled. They respond well to commands. Good pullers, at least 5 of them are. Hercules pulling, but then of course we are going downhill. Alright, so now this turn coming up here is going to be a sharp left-hand turn onto the icy trail. So I'm going to start stop before it, and then, oh, that leader's pooping. There you go, there you go, there you go. Good boy. And just try to get nice and slow around it. Okay, I'm not gonna stop though. There you go, good, good. Ah, good, I prefer to cut it than slam it. Nice. All right, cool, now we're back on the main trail. Whew, it's a fun run up there. I'm glad I did that hill. I'll keep doing that. As long as there's snow and it's not a sheet of ice. If you look at like, Sarabi. Middle dog on the left, Sarabi. Okay, I did ride dog we had. He just pulls and goes, and he's very business-minded. She's good, she's solid, and striped too. Actually, they all are. They're all really good. Different dunderhead here in the back. Cool, there's actually a road right here next to me. And, so this is a public trail. So there's the road, if you can see it, but we are going to turn back on into the woods and head on home. So yeah, so it's the end of March. It's I don't know when you're gonna watch this video, but it's 2020, right? So we are right in the middle of the pandemic, the COVID-19 pandemic right now. So everybody's doing their social distancing pretty much throughout the whole country. Anyway, COVID-19, Alaska, the schools are shut. Most restaurants, if not all of them, are only doing delivery and pickup. We're not on any mandatory shelter in place or anything like that. But the governor has quarantined any visitors that come here. Our mandatory 2 weeks quarantine. And it's kind of nice being in Alaska. You have a little more control of your borders because there's only so many ways to get in. Alright, come down here. I got to slow him down. Whoa, you guys are really picking up speed. Might be something in front of us. Good sun going downhill. All right. Good job, guys. Oh, up there for a minute. Good job, guys. That's it. He got away. That was good. That's why they picked up speed. They're funny. They can sense that stuff. The dogs will, all of a sudden, they'll just be going along, and then they'll be like, whoa, I get a burst of speed. And it is, they're either another person or dog team or moose, right? Moose would be bad, but I'm going to stop here again in a second. Let them get some snow. Poor Merlin. Snow dipping. Oh, let's take a break, you guys. Go ahead. Get your snow. Huh. Hercules, you're not even thirsty. I wonder why. The only dog not eating snow. Yeah. This says a lot, Hercules. Stripe here in the back left, he's actually eating the trail. He's like biting the trail. And when he does it, he scrapes his lips, so I don't know if you can, yeah, you probably can't see it, but there's a little bit of blood from, he's just scraping his lips. Cool, there's going to be a nice little turn up here, a little drop. Yeah, okay. You guys ready? All right. Hey, my, okay, let's go. Thank you. This is the best month. March is the best month in Alaska. It's, the sun is out longer, right? You don't have like 4 hours of sunlight. You have actually like, we have like 14 hours of sunlight now. And the temperatures are, well, you don't know the difference, but usually there's not many people on these trails. There's a lot more people on the trails these days. But the temperatures are warmer, right? You can get snowshoe and ski and bike. And of course, dog mush. But with, and all the snow's here, right? So the snow's here from the whole winter. So here comes that little turn, jeep. Yeah, so people really like March because it's just more sun, warmer temps, all the snow you'd ever want. It's great. My favorite month is for dog mushing, I'd say January, February. Good cool temps, right? Mostly you should have good snow by then. So those are my favorite. Even though it's still kind of dark, I don't mind. I'm usually out when it's light or I wear a headlamp and go out at night. Ooh, it's windy. Windy, windy. My favorite, yeah, I'd say February. Good dog mushing month. And September here is beautiful, right? Still got plenty of lights, but it's starting to get dark, so you can actually sleep at night, because it actually gets dark at night. And trees turn their colors. Yeah, fall here is really nice. I like August too. That cabin over there, she's got probably about 30 sled dogs. She ran the Iditarod at least once. She ran the Iditarod, I don't want to say early 2000s. She's got good dogs. She's got good discipline team. So yeah, cabin there. You might be able to see the dog houses to the left. I have 19 dogs. Well, I have 14 good running sled dogs. I have 3 retirees. I have a pet dog named Sonic. And then I have Hercules, which I'm still figuring out what the heck Hercules is. So, is that 19? It should be 19. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Yes. Good day, guys. That was great. That was a good run. That was fun. Quick, easy. No issues with other dogs or anything. Yeah, sometimes loose dogs on the trail, they'll run into your team. And if that happens, my dog's a pack, right? And you're not from the pack, you can get pounced on. Or if you don't get pounced on, they try to play with them. Either way, my team's all attached, and so it can just be a big tangled mess. So I try not to, I don't like passing loose dogs. I either let them, hopefully the owner can get them. If not, I just go right by them as quick as I can. Sometimes even run over them, just because I don't want my team to stop. Because if my team stops, they can turn on them, turn around, right? If my team turns around, then they just turn into a knot, and that's just not good for anybody. So, all right, we're going back onto my property. I had to put this little stop sign up just because people think it's a trail. So they come to my, they're like, oh, look at this trail. And then they end up in my dog yard. And I don't mind it too much, but you know, they probably don't like having to turn themselves around. And yeah, Anyways, back home, here we go. Nice run, guys. That was fun. We might do another one today. Good job. Up, 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 up. Keep going, guys. All the way in. Keep going all the way in. Up, 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 up. That's it. That's it. That's it. All right. My leader's, yeah, Comet is the one that heats up the most, so drops down, rolls in the snow. There we go. Merlin's rolling. Hercules, you're just a worthless sled dog. I know you are. This is the softest dog, though. Good Lord. The thing about Herc here, yeah, he is so soft. I mean, I got gloves on, but I know he's soft. So soft and very pretty. You're very pretty. Stripe, you're a badass, dude. This guy pulls and pulls and pulls. Look at you. Are you hot? This guy overheats a lot. He got a big coat. It's a Robbie, my little Iditarod dog. It's a Robs. It's a Robbie. There's a Robbie. Hi, sweetheart. How are you? You're so good. Good job today. You did so good. Yeah, this girl is good. And then Leo. My leaders, look at you two. Here, I'm trying to, so you guys maybe can see him before I go and hug him. There, I'm going in. I'm going in. Look at Comet. You guys love your snow. You love your snow. You love your snow. All right, well, that's it. That's it. That's our day. That's a good way to shelter in place, right? All right, I hope you enjoyed the video.